A tragic death in custody and the debate over paperless arrests in the Northern Territory has highlighted the lack of services for the Top End's most vulnerable people, the homeless. While the NT government is crying poor when it comes to funding support services, they have managed to source $1 billion for a supermax prison. The social services sector has been left to pick up the slack, as Danny Teece-Johnson reports.
This is Ozenam House, run by St Vincent de Paul. It's one of the last frontline services in the Top End, feeding the needy. To say it is run on the smell of an oily rag is an understatement.
Ozenam House is a drop-in centre for homeless people or people that are at risk or just need a bit of company. The main things we do here to offer people that need help is provide breakfast early in the morning from about 7:30 and lunch. While they're here, we try and help them connect with services, access medical services and anything else that might help them alleviate their homeless situation.
And while the NT government cracks down on antisocial behaviour, with an approach that one social worker compared to a council street sweeper, it's a vicious cycle of arrests that often ends in jail.
Yeah, we get arrested and plus we get fined from blue paper for no reason.
Every time when I get drunk, I get arrested.
Fine here, so by police. We get our money, we waste our money through by paper. Keep us 24 hours, 7 days a week, paper. Lock we up.
This controversial paperless arrest policy is designed to reduce police paperwork. But combined with ongoing alcohol issues, the jails are filling up fast and hundreds of long grassers are racking up large debts.
Builds up. Now when you get to 3,000 or 2,000, the lock we up for 6 months in prison.
So what's the solution? How can the Northern Territory government reduce these catastrophic Indigenous rates of homelessness and incarceration? Many believe building shelters instead of jails.
One of the big things is a lot of the people that use this service may not be wanting the traditional house. And we see things like the visitors park that's in Alice Springs, something like that run up here, or even just an affordable, non-discriminatory caravan park would help because, you know, there's nowhere for people to go if they can't afford it. There's no real free services. I mean, Vinnie's trying to operate as cheaply as possible, but we've only got so many beds.
So this is Ozenam House. There's not many places like this in Darwin, and it's obvious that the supply does not meet demand in the social services sector. I'm Danny Teece-Johnson, having lunch with a long grass mob for NITV News.